Okay, so good evening class, and today we will start with a new chapter, that is legality of objects and consideration. Okay, in the last class we have completed free consent. We have talked about the topics like coercion, undue influence, fraud, misrepresentation, mistake. So for which, in which case the contract becomes void? Only in case of mistake. And for the other four, the contract is what? The contract is voidable. That is, it is valid at the beginning, but due to certain change circumstances, it becomes invalid. মানে প্রথমে সেটা valid ছিল, কিন্তু পরবর্তীকালে কিছু ঘটনা, কিছু চেঞ্জ হয়ে যাওয়ার কারণে সেটা ক্যান্সেল হয়ে যেতে পারে, ইনভ্যালিড হয়ে যেতে পারে। ওকে, সো টুডে উই উইল স্টার্ট উইথ হোয়াট লিগালিটি অফ অবজেক্টস এন্ড কনসিডারেশন। So this is a small chapter. So let's start. Okay. So what happens? Like, what law allows? What law permits? Law actually permits the things which is under the provisions of law. Law will never allow something which is beyond the provisions of law. We can only do, we can only enter into contracts which the law permits. That is, which is, which are under the provisions of law. Correct. Suppose A hires a serial killer to kill B. A hires a serial killer C for an amount of what? Rupees 10 lakh to kill whom? To kill B. A hires a serial killer C for rupees 10 lakh to kill B. So here the object of the contract, this object, the contract between A and C, the object is illegal. Yes or no? To kill someone, is it legal? No, it is not. Law doesn't allow. It is not under the provisions. It is not within the provisions of the law. So in this case, what happens? The contract becomes void. The contract becomes what? Void. Because whenever the object is illegal, whenever the object is illegal, the contract itself is void. Whenever we are not doing the contract within the provisions of law, we should, there must be a boundary. That is the Lakshman Rekha, you know. Once we cross the Lakshman Rekha, everything is over. Within the Lakshman Rekha, do anything. Do whatever within the provisions of law, but not beyond the provisions of law. If you go beyond the provisions of law, that contract will be a cancelled one. Correct? So in this chapter, basically we will study what? We will study certain cases where the object of the agreement is unlawful and the contract becomes, therefore the contract becomes void. We will talk about the agreements, certain contracts. What happens in those certain agreements and contracts? It so happens that the object is illegal and thereby the contract becomes unlawful. Okay. So let's start. Number one is forbidden by law. Forbidden by law. Suppose A promises what? A promises government service, to provide a government service to B for an amount of 10 lakh. What happens? A promises to provide a government service to whom? To B, for an amount of 10 lakh. Correct? So is this something that law permits? Is government service available by means of money? It should be given, it should be provided on based on what? Based on your qualification, based on your interviews. But here A promises B to give government service for rupees 10 lakh. The amount consideration 10 lakh. Now
সবাই ভাবছে যে ম্যাম কি জানে না নাকি যে আজকাল এইভাবেই চাকরি পাওয়া যায়। ম্যাম সব জানে, ম্যাম নোজ এভরিথিং। দিস ডেজ এভরিথিং ইজ লাইক, এভরিথিং ইজ করাপ্টেড। সো হোয়াট এভার উই আর স্টাডিং ইজ অ্যাকচুয়ালি দিস থিং স্টে ইন দ্য বুকস ওনলি। ইন রিয়েল লাইফ দ্য প্র্যাকটিক্যাল থিং ইজ, ইফ ইউ হ্যাভ মানি অ্যান্ড পাওয়ার, ইউ ক্যান ডু এনিথিং, স্পেশালি হিয়ার ইন ওয়েস্ট বেঙ্গল। If you have money and power, you could do anything. And I think most of my students will agree with to it. Money and power can buy you everything. But it's not possible for everyone to have money and power to buy jobs. So you all have to prepare yourself. You all have to stand out amongst the, in the rat race, you all have to stand out.
বিকজ দ্যাট সামথিং এলস অ্যান্ড বাইং আ জব ইজ সামথিং এলস দ্যাট মিনস আই ডোন্ট গিভ ভ্যালু টু অল দোজ থিংস আই পার্সোনালি ডোন্ট গিভ ভ্যালু টু অল দোজ থিংস ইট মাইট টেক টাইম ফর ইউ অল টু স্ট্যান্ড বাট ইউ উইল স্ট্যান্ড ওয়ান ডে সো ওয়েট ফর ইউর মোমেন্ট অ্যান্ড প্রিপেয়ার ইউর সেলফ ওকে So this type of promise that I will provide you government service is something which is forbidden by law. So this type of contract, so if A, if B, means if B gives A 10 lakh and after that A doesn't provide government service, B ko tha jabe? Where will B go to complain? And B jodi complain korte chahe, if B goes to complain, first charge will be against B only. That how dare B have given money for government service? So this type of contract is what a void contract. Is it clear? Number two. If it is of such nature that defeats the provisions of any law. Defeats the provision of any law. Defeats the provision of any law. If it is of such nature that defeats the provision of any law. So what is this? Defeats the provision of any law. Suppose Salman was given license to open a liquor shop. But with the condition that Salman can never transfer the ownership or create any kind of partnership with someone else. Means this shop's ownership cannot be transferred by Salman to any other person, or Salman cannot take any other person in partnership. Based on that condition, the license was granted. But what Salman does? Salman first agrees to all the terms and condition and takes the license. But after a year, Salman takes Shahrukh Khan as his partner. Salman takes Shahrukh as his partner. Correct? But what did the law say? What did the law permit? Only Salman could run the shop. Nobody could come and take the ownership, or nobody could come as a partner. So here, what is happening? Salman defeated the provision of law. The law said something, but Salman did the opposite. So the license will get cancelled if somehow they got to know this. And the contract will become void. Correct? Is it clear? So something that defeats the provision of the law, something that is forbidden by law. That is, law doesn't allow. Understood the difference? Here it is forbidden. Here law doesn't permit. And here the law have permitted based on certain circumstances, based on certain condition. And if you fail to fulfill that condition, then that is, you're defeating the provision. If you are failing to fulfill the condition, means you are defeating. Tumi jodi fulfill na korte paro, tumi tale provision gulo ke defeat korcho. Then the contract will become invalid. Clear? Number three. Fraudulent. What is fraudulent? Again, same thing. Fraud means with an intention. When we do something with an intention to deceive the other person. So, fraudulent. Suppose Kareena and Karishma planned to share the money they gained by means of robbery. Ki holo? Churi kore, rob kore, by robbing someone, Kareena and Karishma has gained certain amount of money. Kareena and Karishma have gained certain amount of money by robbing someone. Kauke rob kore, kauke churi kore, karu taka mereche, shoja kotha, taka churi koreche. And they have made a contract that they will share this amount. But is such contract a valid contract? Does law provide all this robbery? No, robbery is illegal itself. So such contract is a void. Now if it can so happen that Kareena, after robbing, runs away and doesn't give any amount of share to Karishma, can Karishma go to the police station or go to the court against Kareena to just do a case against Kareena? First of all, Karishma will be arrested because of robbing and then they will find Kareena. So this type of contract is a void contract. Is it clear?
Fraudulent.
Next, injurious to person or property of another. Suppose again, if he injurious to what? Injurious to person or property of some another person. Suppose Kareena enters into a contract with Karishma. Kareena enters into a contract with Karishma to share the land or to share the crops of the land. To share the crops of the land of Abhishek. How? They will steal the crops, they will sell the crops, and Kareena and Karishma will distribute amongst themselves the profit. So land is crop takar, jomi takar, Abhishekir. Crop ekhane ki hoche, foshol takar, Abhishekir. But Kareena and Karishma are entering into a contract to steal it, to sell the crops, and the profit to distribute among both of them. So who is suffering? Abhishek, the third person, is suffering. Someone's property is getting damaged. Someone is getting injured. So this type of contract is also an illegal contract. Void contract. Because we are hurting someone. We are destroying someone's property. That is also not a valid one. So first one, what? It is forbidden by law. Second, it defeats the provisions of law. Third, it's fraudulent in nature. Fourth, what? Fourth, it is injurious to person or property. Correct?